The battle at the boardroom continues at Okada Manila. Tiger Resort Leisure and Entertainment Incorporated, or TRLEI, has filed cases of kidnapping, serious illegal detention, grave coercion, and unjust vexation against the camp of Japanese tycoon Kazuo Okada. TRLEI showed to the media footage of what they call the violent takeover of Okada Manila last May 31st. They claim they were dragged out of the hotel and casino premises by private guards while one of the Japanese directors of TRLEI, Hajime Tokuda, was forced to enter a vehicle.
Siya po ay kinidnap, siya po ay dinukot mula sa meeting room kung saan kami po ay nagmi-meeting. Siya po ay binuhat ng mga goons nina Tony Boy Kawangko at siya ay dinala sa isang sasakyan na hindi niya kilala. At siya po ay sinakay tapos kung saan siya dinala at eventually siya po ay inuwi na sa bahay.
The incident stems from a Supreme Court ruling issuing a status quo ante order in April, urging parties to maintain the status quo prevailing prior to the removal of Kazuo Okada as stockholder, director, chairman, and CEO of TRLEI. Okada was removed in 2017 due to allegations of mismanagement and corruption. Following his removal, Okada filed cases at the lower court, but they were all dismissed until the SC granted his petition for a status quo ante order last April. With the takeover last May 31, Okada now controls Okada Manila, appointing Tony Boy Kwangku as president and a new set of board directors. But Hong Kong-based Tiger Resort Asia, which owns TRLEI, asserts it does not recognize Kazuo Okada and his new management team. Even Kazuo Okada's estranged wife, Takako, who is a director of Tiger Resort Asia, calls the takeover a violent act.
If they truly cared about the Philippines and the more than 5,000 employees working at Okada Manila, they should have come at us in a reasonable and lawful manner.
The TRA, the owner of 99.99% shareholdings of TRLEI, does not recognize this sham board. So whatever transactions or acts it enters into on behalf of the company will not be honored.
El Amparo says Okada only had one share out of 5 billion shares prior to his removal as head of Okada Manila. So he has no authority to control the management. TRLEI now plans to file a motion for the Supreme Court to clarify the bounds and coverage of the status quo ante order. Okada Manila's operations continue as of the moment, but El Amparo reveals the camp of Okada is prevented from accessing TRLEI's bank accounts. She hopes the intra-corporate scandal will be resolved soon as this incident could send a bad signal to investors. Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation Chairperson Andrea Domingo, for her part, says PAGCOR's role is to observe the law and, in this case, the Supreme Court status quo ante order. ABS-CBN tried to get the side of Kazuo Okada's camp, but their group says they won't be able to accommodate the media's requests for now. But in an earlier press statement, Kazuo Okada's group denied there was a violent takeover, asserting that it was a peaceful enforcement of the SC order. In his speech during a town hall with senior managers Monday, Kazuo Okada, who now sits as chairman, said it is his fervent desire for all stakeholders to know that his board of directors is sincere in its pursuit to better serve the needs of its employees while at the same time elevating Okada Manila to greater heights of success. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.